Yes, sir.
Then he told you what you have to do. None but the righteous shall see God. Get ready. Let's go home. Brother Wise has been singing.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Amen. Instead of the resurrection Sunday, I thought he was in a studio. Cutting a CD or something. I look back one time, I had never seen that much movement in my life. It was rolling back then.
Yeah.
Amen. That's right. That's what happens when we give it to God.
That's right. That's right. Power in the blood. Yeah.
I thank God for this day and this Resurrection Sunday. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I just bless his name. I just give him all the honor and glory and praise. Amen. For what he done for us. Amen. If you think about it, our Savior went through a lot for us. Amen. I mean, if you really read the story, amen. That mouth right there make you get right. For a man to go through so much so that we can have the right to the tree of life and live abundantly. God bless his name. Can nobody do me like Jesus. Nobody do me like the Lord. Amen. That's why I'm willing to go all the way. Because for what he done for us. If he sacrificed that much for us, I can give that little to him and let it be in spirit and in truth. Amen. I hear three amens. God bless his name. I give him honor and glory and praise. I thank God for the preachers that grace God roster. Amen to the deacons and all the officers in it, all the preachers out in the pews. Amen. We thank God. Amen.
Amen.
Thank God for your choir, y'all doing well.
Amen.
You see what happens once you get together. Huh? You get together, though. Lord have mercy. Once you get together, you talk about moving some mountains. Yeah. I think someone preached on the Sunday about getting together or something like that. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Right in here.
Amen. Everything you need.
Amen. Amen.
not going to hold you long here. If you have your Bible, let's turn to the 20th chapter of Matthew. 28th chapter of Matthew. I'm going to read the 5th, 6th, and the 7th verse. 28th chapter of Matthew. 5, 6, and 7. I need you. Amen. And in your spare time, I want you to go back and read Ecclesiastes, that very chapter, because my message is going to send me there also.
Amen.
Amen. Here in the living word, the Bible declared that, said that, the angel said to the woman, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here. He has risen, just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly." Somebody said, "Go quickly."
Go quickly.
"And tell his disciples he has risen from the dead and is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him. Now I have told you." That's the end of the reading of that. And as I said, when you get a chance, go back and get your chapter. And read those 8 verses of the 3rd chapter. With the permission of the Holy Spirit, I want to talk from the subject this morning. Timing is very important.
Amen.
He is risen.
Yes.
Timing is very important because he is risen. I know that he, subject seem a little off base, but as the Lord was giving it to me, I realized that a lot of people think they still have a long time, a lot of time, but time is winding up. We don't have the time that we think.
Yeah.
Well, if you read your Bibles and meditate on it, a lot of things, Brother Ricky, already have come to pass.
Yes, sir.
I stop by to tell you, timing is very important. But I'm so glad that even on last week here, they crucified our Savior. But one thing about it that they didn't realize that he was going to get up again. See, just like the disciples, they heard what Jesus was saying, but they wasn't listening. Huh? Because he told them, he said, "In 3 days, I'm going to rise again." See, we hear, but we don't listen. Even in this text, He said that on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and other Mary went to look at the tomb.
Yes.
Look at the disciples. Where were the disciples? Somewhere hiding. In a room. But the Bible said there was a violent earthquake.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
For the angel of the Lord came down from heaven and going to the tomb, rolled back the stone.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That's what they did.
Then he rolled back the stone, then he sat on it.
Come on.
He said he sat on it. Because I believe the angel knew that he had fulfilled his mission.
Yes, sir.
See, his mission was just to come down and roll the stone away.
Yeah.
It wasn't for him to do nothing else.
That's right.
See, he didn't get in the lane where Mary's supposed to be in.
Right.
He stayed in his lane.
Stayed in his lane. That's right.
Help me, Holy Ghost.
Help him, Holy Ghost.
But the Bible said here, his appearance was like lightning.
Yes, sir.
That's right. Keep telling me, preacher.
Preach.
Give me a little more firepower,
sir. Yes,
sir. His appearance was like lightning.
Yeah.
And his clothes was white as snow.
Yes, yes, yes.
But look at here. He said, that the gods were so afraid of him that they shook and became like dead men. You know, the angel's clothes was white. But the thing about it is, if y'all don't mind, I want to talk about, don't be afraid. Number two, he is risen. Number three, come and see. And number four, go quickly and tell. See, y'all don't mind going and tell something bad.
No.
This is the day that you should be going and tell something bad. Oh my God. But the Bible said, don't be afraid. The reality of the resurrection brings joy, not fear. We should be rejoiced. Because of the resurrection. Can I get a witness here? Because he isn't here. Jesus is not dead. It is not to be looked upon the dead. So if he's not dead, why are you looking among the dead? Brother Ricky, that took me back over to the book of Ecclesiastes. Well, that's a time for everything. Can I get a witness there? You look at that book of Ecclesiastes, that third chapter. That really pertains to our life. Said there's a time for everything. Don't you know that you got a season? Come on, Holy Ghost, help me out. You got time and a season. Because one thing about it is, you don't plant. If you plant in the spring, it'll come up in the summer.
That's right, that's right.
Can I get a witness say?
Come on.
But the Bible said there's a season for every activity under the sun. But I stopped by this morning to tell you that I don't care who you are. You're going to have a good season
and a bad season.
Can I get a witness say? All four of your seasons is not going to be good. Y'all don't want to talk to me. But the Bible said there's a time to be born and a time to die. Timing is very important. Ladies, you know that when you get ready to have the baby, you try to narrow it down closer than you can. The time. That is very important. But the only thing I stop by to tell you, you can't put time on God. That's what time. You cannot put time on death. But look at here. I just want to share this with you. You see, there's a time to plant, and there's a time to root. See, this is the season. Even start today. You ought to start planting.
That's right.
You should go back home and tell your family about Jesus.
Yes, sir.
You should go back to your job tomorrow and tell somebody that yesterday my Savior wrote. That's why I'm saved, sanctified, Holy Ghost filled. And there is a time in our life we need to uproot. Because we got so much mess down there. It needs to be uprooted. See, what happened here? This off. It's going to come back again. You need to get to the root. Pull it up. That's why some go back to the bottle and some start still hitting drugs because they haven't got to the root of it. Once you get to the root, let God get to the root, pull it out. You don't want no more. You don't want to chase nobody else's wife. You don't want to sleep with another woman. You got that up. The Bible said there's a time to kill and a time to heal. Now that just don't mean you'll take no gun and go out and kill nobody. But it's just like uprooting. We got stuff inside that we ought to kill. Can I get a witness here? Yes. That mess on the inside, that comfortable, and God is displeased. We can kill it with the Holy Ghost and through the word. And the same with the word of God, kill it, then the word of God will turn around and heal you.
Yes, it will.
What you mean, man? How can you come to church with malice in your heart? How can you come to church with an attitude because somebody sung your song? You don't have a song.
Come on,
how can you talk about I'm supposed to be in the center aisle? You got me against the wall. You put away the lady or the man tell you to go. It's a time, church, to tell them, and a time to be. This is where all of us take a part. All this mess that's going around in these churches, we ought to get together, start praying, and tell out this mess. Don't no one or two person run nothing. God is in charge. And once we start praying to God, He'll build the church. I'm trying to be nice for guessing now. But let me tell you something. God told me, said, let me tell you something. And this is going for me. If I try to handle the church, I'm going to move you. He can move you through sickness. Or he can move you through death. Can I get on this hell? You got to be obedient. Lord, have mercy. Can I say it, Ricky? See, God appointed me here as the under shepherd. Can I get on this hell? I don't have to go to nobody else. God tell me what to do. Then I tell the rest what to do. How are you going to build the church? See, here I've had people around here that won't run the church, but no more. This church is going to be built by God. Because I'm praying and asking Him. Everyone that tried to enter the church, move. If I had to go, I got to go. But I'm asking to move. Because it's not planned. Can I get a witness here? This is serious time. The world is hungry for the living word. They don't want to come into the church where messy. They can stay out in the world. The Bible said there's a time to laugh. And there's a time to weep. Can I get a witness here? Lord, have mercy. The Bible said, weep with those who weep and rejoice with those who rejoice. Can I get a witness here? We should be weeping. Thank you, Jesus. For the one that's suffering, we should be weeping. For the one that's being mistreated, y'all don't hear me. This is weeping time. And see, if we weep with them and pray for them, then we can look back and laugh and say, look what God done. Can I get a witness here? Y'all don't want to talk to me this morning. So God, He is the Alpha and the finisher of my faith. Can I get a witness here? I'm trying to finish up this thing here. But the Bible says a time to mourn and a time to dance. Can I get a witness here? I see you, Sister Norris. Looking good, Dad. It's a time to mourn and there's a time to dance. Can I get a witness here? I stop by to tell you, you know when you see it, that's the time to mourn. You need to get down on your knees and ask God for forgiveness. Can I get a witness here? Yes, it's morning time. That's what's going to clean your heart, clean the spirit, clean the soul when you truly repent. The time is very important. And once you get clean, that's when you really can dance. Can I get a witness here? See, some people dance off emotion. Some people dance because they got that feeling hurt. But when you get clean on inside, you don't need no music. Can I get a witness here? You don't need no people around you. Because the Spirit of God will get all in your feet, get in your hand. Can I get a witness here? Yes! Lord, have mercy. Have you ever been dry, praying and praising God, and seeing like your feet just can't stay on the path? Sometimes you're riding along, and you just be waving to God. God pass you looking at you. There's a time you want to dance, but you can't because you're driving. But you're giving praise to God. Lord, have mercy. One thing I stop by to tell you, you don't have no special place that you can praise God. I'll praise Him in the corner. I'll praise Him in the house. The women's hand, wherever I feel the joy of the Lord. Yes, I know He's present. Can I get a women's hand? Anybody ever felt Him? Have you done? Have you ever been in the grocery store and you met somebody? You all began to talk about Jesus, and all of a sudden, you get the swing in your hand. God with his hate. See, we should be hating. See. And as I say, we should be hating the way they mistreat these children. See, these are the things we should be hating. Not one another, but the sin. Lord have mercy. See, when I came up as a little child, and when they saw you doing something bad, they would call you to the side and say, look at here. That's nothing but sin. Can I get a witness now? You got to call sin out. Can I get a witness now? See, if you don't call sin out, more you stay around sin, you get comfortable with it. And after a while, you'll find yourself doing the same thing. Can I get a witness here? If I go home and be cursing, can I get a witness here? If Jackie don't say something, then when the grands come around, they hear granddaddy cursing. They gon' think it's right. Next thing you know, Jackie gonna be cursing. The little one cursing. The whole grand family cursing. Somebody got to cut. And it's not all about cursing. It's about having these men in y'all bed that you're not mine. They got children. How do you think your child feel when they wake up and see a man and it's not his dad? That's why these children right today are angry. It's time to pluck up. I know y'all don't like Pastor Graham, but I'm trying to help somebody. You got to pluck up. What you mean pluck up? Pluck that Negro up and tell him to get out. Get right. myself sometimes. But I'm just like Jesus. Lord, I commit my spirit back to you in your hand. Can I get a witness hand? I'm so glad. I'm so glad. I can see old Pilate. Old Pilate was so worried to death. Going from judgment hall to judgment hall. But one thing about Pilate, he knew that he didn't have nothing on Jesus. Can I get a witness here? But I'm so glad that my Savior wouldn't say a word. And one day, he started talking about authority and power. Jesus spoke up and said, you don't have no power. Because all the power comes from my Father. Can I get a witness here? I'm so glad that when he started up going out the hill, he was thinking about us. Can I get a witness here? That the Father wants us to come back to him. Can I get a witness here? But I'm so glad. I'm so glad that he kept going up Golgotha Hill. Can I get a witness here? Yes. Can you imagine in your mind when you're going up the Golgotha Hill, you see that old big cross laying on the ground. Good God from Zion. But he said, I got to go because I got to do my Father's will. Can I get a witness here? Then you turn him to the cross. They nail his hand. They nail his feet. Put a thorn around his head. Lord have mercy. And then they had the audacity to put him between two feet. Can I get a witness here? But one thing they forgot. When you start to raise him up. Yes. Lord have mercy, because he already had told us, if I be lifted up, I'm going to do some drawing. Can I get a witness here? But that didn't stop them. They put him down in the hole with Jesus hanging on the cross. Good God from Zion. But look at the thief. One was talking smack. Can I get a witness here? And the other one said, you are the Son of God. And Jesus looked at him, said, this day you will be with me in paradise. I'm so glad. Can I ask a question here? If Jesus looked at you, would he tell you you're going to be with him in paradise? Can I get a witness here? But one thing, Sister Bodie, that when I was praying and talking to God, I said, why was it 3 days? He said, one was for justification, one for sanctification, and the third day was for salvation. Can I get a witness here? I said, good God from Zion, justification, sanctification, then salvation. We wouldn't have salvation if he hadn't died and got up that early that morning. Can I get a witness here? But I look at the story. How Mary, Magdalene, and Mary the mother was sitting there at the tomb waiting when the angel rolled the stone away. Lord have mercy. Yes. Who are you looking for? Who are you looking for? St. Judy, who are you looking for? Why are you looking? He's already here. I'm not going to witness that. But he told him, said, he's ground here. He ain't risen. Lord have mercy. Why look at the dead among the dead? Good God from Zion. I stopped by to tell you, when the 3 days that he was in the tomb, I don't believe he was dead, but he was just waiting to get up early. him and put him in the tomb. How he had to stay there. Had to suffer. Can I get a witness out? Lord, have mercy. This little suffering that we go through is nothing. Can I get a witness out? But let me tell you, Sister Morgan, every time you go through something, you get higher and higher. Can I get a witness out? When people try to cut you down, they pushing you closer to the end of God. Can I get a witness out? They think you're hungry, but the only thing they're doing is pushing you closer to the kingdom. Can I get a witness out? So let them talk. Talk ain't never hurt nobody. But I double teeth day. You pray while they're talking. You pray while they're doing. Yes! I thank you, preacher, for praying for me. Because one thing I had to realize, I'm more than a conqueror. Can I get a witness out? When he died, when he rose, he said, I got all power in my hand. He said, you are more than a conqueror. Can I get a witness out? How many who walk into the will of God? No man can stop you. They might try to hurt you. You might play the will of God again, but you won't fall. Can I get a witness here? Have anybody ever been down? Have anybody ever been down? And Jesus picked you up. Somebody ought to tell him thank you. Somebody ought to tell him thank you. You can see your way out. Lord have mercy. Give God some Zion. Yes. Didn't have two nickels rubbed together. Husband walked away from you. Children start acting crazy, but you stayed on your knees. Can I get a witness here? You got to stay there, because when they walk away, God walked in. He said, I'll be your husband. I'll be your father to the children. I'll be the mother too. I will supply all of your need. I'm calling to my riches and glory. Preach it, Brad. I thank God for sending his son. I thank his son for giving up his life so we can have part. This is the Holy Ghost. That's what makes me want to run. That's what makes me want to shout. That's what makes me want to run home. See what the end gonna be. Yeah! I hear them say, down there. We can endure for a night. But joy, God knows joy. Joy is coming in the morning. You don't have to wait till you cross joy. But joy is on this side. Can I go with his hand? I have joy down in my soul. Jesus, I got the whole world in my hand. See, I don't need no good. Only thing I need is a pure heart and clean hands. So when I start to pray, he hear my prayer. Can I get a witness here? You don't need no God. For a lot of stuff else I can tell you don't need. But you need prayer. Can I get a witness here? He said, pray ye for one another. I can't stop praying because you don't like me. But I got to pray for you. In spite of. Can I get a witness here? That's how your blessings come. I pray for your enemies. I pray for the one that's talking about you. The one that don't like you. Pray for them and see what God will do. Can I get a witness here? I somebody tell you, until you get into the will of God, nothing gonna work right for you. Can I get a witness here? Nothing's not gonna work right for you. But once you get in his will, what looked impossible, he'll make it possible. Can I get a witness here? I get this here and tell somebody, if you just give your life to me and live by my commandments, that business that you want, I will supply the needs. Oh my God. You might get the business, don't even have to put no money down. Can I get a witness here? But you got to walk up right. Like Reverend Cooper said, the more you walk with him, the more he'll show you. People don't believe that. Amen, amen, amen. You'll see a rat run across the floor and know when a snake is coming. But it's gonna cost you something. It's gonna cost you something. Can I get a witness? It's gonna cost you something. You're gonna be tested. You're gonna be tested. And if you don't have it, you're gonna fail the test. Huh?